So this E will go out of the integral, and we have integral on a closed surface, and here dA will come in, and this is equal to Q over epsilon naught here. Now I know about dA that this is the sphere area, and this integral is equal to 4 pi r square. Because d is equal to r square sine theta d theta d phi, when we will integrate it, r square is constant here, so there is no integration on r square, and sine theta d phi will give us 4 pi. So the area of the sphere is 4 pi r square, and from here I can write that electric field comes out to be 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught and Q over R squared, which is exactly the field we calculated for a point charge, or which is exactly the field we calculated from the Coulomb's law. And that was the reason that I told you at that moment that this R square term, 1 over r square term, is basically due to the spherical geometry. And when we say that it is an inverse square law, basically the geometry was such that it gave us the 1 over r square term. If Coulomb would have used any other kind of geometry, then it may have resulted in a different r dependence. So here E comes out to be 4 pi epsilon naught r square, and this just behaves like means whether you enclose a big sphere with charge Q or you enclose a point charge with charge Q, then the electric field at a distance r will be the same. And that's the reason. And it is also, if I write the vector form, then this is radially outward, because at each point this will be radially outward. And in this example, although we have not been asked for calculating the electric field inside the sphere, but in the problem we will have to calculate the electric field inside the sphere. Like we are in problem 2.11, we will have to calculate the electric field inside and outside of a spherical shell of radius r. While in problem 2.12, we will have to calculate the electric field inside a uniformly charged sphere which is having charge density rho. So this is part of this example, and problem is coming on that one. So is in these lecture series, I'm not going to solve the problems but only the topic and the examples. But I will do this here because this is important to do this thing at this point. So let's say we are now, this is the field which is outside, the sphere. And then what about the field inside the sphere? So we will calculate that field which will be inside the sphere. And let me now consider here. This is a sphere which is inside it, and here is the observation point, for example. This is the observation point, and now this is the distance r here. And this is observation point P. Now here we know that we will have to calculate how much charge is enclosed by our Gaussian sphere, and that we will have to calculate. Rest of the equation is the same. So do calculate this one, and here I will again write that on a closed surface this E dot dA is equal to Q enclosed over epsilon naught here. Is we have here Q enclosed over epsilon naught, and now we will find how much charge is being enclosed here. And if I look here, let's say we are having now the charge density of this one is equal to rho, and we will find this thing. So for to calculate this one, I'm writing this side. So it will be again the same thing, like it will be 4 pi epsilon naught, for this is E here, means on this sphere, if I consider this sphere and charge is this much, then the field is radially outward here, and I will have the same situation E, and then integral on a closed surface, and this is dA, and this is equal to E times the area of the sphere, this sphere, the Gaussian sphere. This comes out to be 4 pi r squared. This is the area of this sphere. And then this is equal to the charge which is enclosed here by epsilon naught here. So what is the enclosed charge? This is a question. If our Gaussian sphere would be exactly on the surface of it, then it will enclose all the charge. And if it is half of this one, then it will enclose half of the available charge. But we don't know how much it has enclosed, but how much this R radius is enclosing inside this one, we will calculate that one. So for the Q enclosed, we know that this is a solid sphere, and this will be equal to rho d tau, and rho is constant, means rho is all over the sphere. This is volume charge density is constant, and this is equal to rho times the volume of this Gaussian sphere, and this is 4 by 3 pi r cube. This much charge has been enclosed by our Gaussian sphere, and this will make this thing equal to, from here, rho is constant, so I will write another thing here, and rho is what? This is the charge per unit volume, and the volume is 4 by 3 pi r cube, because this is the r of the radius of the charge sphere, multiplied by 4 by 3 pi small r cube. How much this one is enclosing here? And 4 by 3 pi is cancelled with 4 by 3 pi, and we are left with here with q times r cube over r cube here. So put the values here. This implies that E times 4 pi r square is equal to 1 over epsilon naught times and q, and then r cube over capital R cube. Now here I know that this is cancelling here. This r square will go with here with r cube, so one r will remain, and we will have the electric field equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught. So this is q over 4 pi epsilon naught, and r over r cube. And this is the electric field. Let me write it in a more fancier form. This is 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught in Q R over R cube. Now, if I look to this thing dimensionally, then this is Q over R square dimensionally. 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q over R square dimensionally. So, it means dimension-wise, whatever we have derived is right. And what does it mean? It means that as R is increasing, R is growing, and it is reaching to R, the electric field is also growing. Like as this R is growing and reaching to R, to this surface, means the solid sphere, then the electric field is increasing linearly. Because here we know that E is proportional. All these parameters, Q is constant, 4 pi epsilon naught constant, R is constant. So, E is proportional to R. And when this R becomes equal, this R becomes equal to R, when both are the same, then we are having the electric field is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught in Q over R squared, which is the field that we have derived here for the outside. We are now on the surface of this one, and we know that as R is growing, as R is increasing now, then the field is decreasing is 1 over R square. As R goes to infinity, E goes to 0. So if I do plot this thing, then if for example we are having this is the central point here and here. If in this direction I am having R and in this direction I am having field, then I know that this is the central point. Now if I mark here, for example, this is the radius of the sphere and I drop it here on this one, on the axis, then I know from here that when this R is increasing and this reaches the value R, the electric field, let's say this is the maximum value it is having, so this is increasing is linearly, is R, it is increasing, is R is increasing from 0 to, when it is at 0, it is enclosing, no charge field is equal to 0. It is growing, then it is enclosing more and more charge and the electric field is increasing linearly. E is proportional to R. And when it reaches the surface here, and after that when R is increasing, then the field is decreasing is 1 over R square. So it is decreasing like this. This is the field when we are having the electric field decreasing is 1 over R square. So if we have a situation like this one, then we will have the field situation like this. And now in the same example, I can do problem 2.11 as well. And 2.11 is very easy. I can draw here a sphere. And the sphere is, let's say now in problem 2.11, we are having a spherical shell. So let's say this is a spherical shell that we have. Okay, and the spherical shell is having its radius equal to R. Shell means that it is empty from inside and the whole charge is residing on the surface of it and let's say it is having Q charge here, and we are supposed to find out the field outside. Is we got the field outside here, and here we got the field inside. This is the field inside of a solid sphere. Now here we are going to find out the field outside of this. So we consider, let's say at this point we are going to calculate the field, and this is at a distance r from here, small r. So our Gaussian sphere is something like this. Here around it we are considering a Gaussian sphere, and this sphere is of radius r. Then again we go to the Gauss's law, and for outside field, for outside, we are having integral on a closed surface, and E dot dA here is equal to Q enclosed over epsilon naught. Now this implies, I will now not go into that calculation, but this is E n times area. So E, the absolute value here, and the area is 4 pi r square of our Gaussian sphere, and the enclosed charge here is Q, because this sphere is enclosing the whole charge, and it is equal to Q over epsilon naught, and this implies that E is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught and Q over R square. If I find the vectorial form, then this is E vector and this is radially outward. And when I see here, then the outside field here in this situation in a spherical shell and the outside field here in a solid sphere, it is the same, because we have nothing to do whether it is a spherical shell, whether it is filled inside or it is not filled inside. What thing we are going to count is how much charge our Gaussian sphere is enclosing, and it is enclosing this much charge Q, and it is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught. And now when we will be calculating the field inside, let's say we are calculating the field inside this spherical shell, and now this is a distance r, so we will consider a sphere, and the sphere is such that it is having this radius r now. And again for the inside of this, for the inside field, we will write that again the Gauss's law on a closed surface, E dot dA is equal to Q enclosed over epsilon naught. Now this side will give E dot dA, and it will be E times 4 pi r square. But what about here? How much charge our Gaussian sphere is enclosing? Our Gaussian sphere is enclosing no charge, because it's a spherical shell. It is empty inside. Charge is on the surface. So our Q enclosed is equal to zero, and this makes our electric field equal to zero inside a spherical shell. So this is problem 2.11, in which we were supposed to calculate the field inside and outside the spherical shell.